Alright, so I'm watching the Blender Data Tips and Tricks, and this, of course, is lesson number 54. So in this video, we're going to talk about the camera tricks and the camera tips. So basically, let's start by making some scene to explain the camera options. As I've mentioned before, if you have the mouse wheel is defective, you can go to the user preferences and emulate a 3-button mouse. And after that, you can use not using the middle mouse, but so you can now use the Alt with right click. Let me go again, emulate 3-button and Alt left click to rotate, and Alt shift to pan, and Alt control to zoom in and zoom out. So this is very useful trick if you have the mouse wheel not working in your device. Alright, so we have some camera here, and this camera is in the layer 2. So basically, you have the camera. If you select the camera in the viewport, or you select in the outliner, you will see this camera option. So there is a lot of options here. The first one, which is the focal lens. So if you click control, if you click 0, you can go to the viewport of this camera. And of course, you can increase the alpha or decrease this alpha. You can view only this viewport or like this, or you can view the whole scene like this. And after that, you have the focal length. So the focal length in the real life or in the real world is zooming in and zooming out, and this is parameter of your lens, of course. And if you are using the macro lens, you can go from 90 to around 105. So the macro lens is a close up, using the macro lens to make close up shots. And we are now here simulating the real lens by using some focal lens. And of course, if you have an interior scene or an exterior scene, you can go of a focal lens of 20 or 15 or something such as a 25 or 22. So this for if you are using if you are using an exterior scene or an interior scene or architecture visualization, so use this focal lens range from 15 up to 25. And after that, you have the camera preset. So these are some preset, and each camera of course has some sensor wide such as this. So the iPhone has small sensor such as this, and the small sensor mean the small light will come into your scene and the more noise you will get. So make sure that you have an such a large sensor such as red, this one, which is the red epic, or something such as something like this. So this preset has focal length of 4, and you can of course increase this focal length. And this is the wide, and this is the sensor width. And after that, we have some options here. So after that, you have the display. We can display the thirds. So this is for compositing. And as you can see here, as you see in an iPhone or any camera, DSLR camera, you have this compositing guides, which you can place your item or character inside this one. And we have, of course, a lot of options here. And after that, we have the limits. So the limits, of course, is using this option, this yellow, let me explain. This one you can use for the focus. And these items is determined the length of focus. So let me explain the depth of field. But before that, if you are in the display, you can display something here. I mean in the shading. If you are in the shading, you can display the depth of field. Of course, you can display the ambient occlusion, such as this. You can use the ambient occlusion, but we want to display the depth of field. But I think because we are not in the camera, so this is the depth of field, of course. So we'll focus in here, and you'll see that let's go here. as you can see, we are focused on here and not here. I have make this animation to have animating the focus or the depth of field. So let's play our animation to see what we have get. So we are now focusing here, and the focus will start to go from this area. As you can see, this is the focus item, which is an MBT, object. And as you can see, we are now focusing, and the focusing is sliding such as this. So you can display the depth of field, and this is the most useful trick that you can use. Instead of rendering a whole images, you can rendering only the OpenGL these files to make a test for the focusing. So here we are not focusing on anything, and here we are focusing on the depth of field. So let me explain something. If you go here, maybe in this frame, and we have this focus. So basically you can select any item such as this or any MBT, because the MBT you can animate. So we have selected the MBT so that you can not rendering any item such as this. As you can't select this item and animate, because this will destroy your geometry. Then we have selected this focus, and we have selected the f-stop, not the radius, and also we have animated this one. So this is the aperture, which is the opening of the lens of your camera, and it's ranging from, depending on this value, let us go the camera and going to select this using Shift Z, and as you can see, there is focus here on this area, and the larger number mean the less of the focusing, and the less number of this f-stop. So if you go to a number such as one, you will get more depth of field and get more focusing. So I hope you enjoy this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.